Her Excellency Sheikh Hasina, the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Honorable Ministers, Excellencies, Distinguished Invitees, Ladies and Gentlemen, Aibuan. I am delighted to be present here today in Dhaka to participate in an occasion of historic significance for the people of Bangladesh. Therefore, let me thank Her Excellency the Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina for a cordial invitation to me and my delegation and the warm welcome given on my arrival. Despite many challenges posed by the COVID-19 pandemic, I join you in person today with a message of solidarity from the people of Sri Lanka. The friendly relations between our two countries have a long history. Many scholars believe that the first migrant from Bengal arrived in Sri Lanka through maritime routes as far back as 2005, more than 2,500 years ago. It is also believed that Sri Lanka and Bangladesh had vibrant trade exchanges since 6th century BC. Quite naturally, Sri Lanka was one of the first countries to establish diplomatic relations with the new nation of the People's Republic of Bangladesh in 1971. The people of Bangladesh are celebrating two historic events. One is the birth of the father of their nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, a century ago. And the second is the birth of Bangladesh, a half century ago. Both events are worthy of celebration. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman was a person of principles who dedicated his entire life for the Bengali people, their language, and their well-being. He was determined to continue his freedom struggle until the creation of a new nation of Bangladesh in 1971. Unfortunately, he could not live to realize the dreams he nurtured for his beloved country. Your Excellency, I understand the agony of the immense loss that occurred on the 15th of August 1975. On that day, the nation lost the hero and the father of independence. At the same time, a beloved daughter lost her parents and siblings. Madam Prime Minister, despite huge setbacks, Bangladesh continues to flourish under your able leadership. That is the best honor in the name of your esteemed father. As a tribute to his legacy and in dedication to Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, let me quote a part of a poem written by a Bengali, Guru Rabindranath Tagore. I quote, "Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake." Unquote. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, in this 21st century, with the great aspiration for Asian prosperity, our new generations need to be aware of the countless sacrifices made by their forefathers to achieve freedom. has a neighbor and a close friend. Sri Lanka stands side by side with the Bangladesh to achieve greater freedom and prosperity. Our objective of economic transformation, eradication of poverty, and achieving the sustainable development goals remain three priorities in the middle of a great challenge. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman said, Bangladesh is fertile and endowed with plenty. Few countries in the world have the kind of fertile land that we have. The geographical location of our two countries provide ample opportunities for us to enhance closer maritime, shipping, trade, and people-to-people contacts. Madam Prime Minister, your proposal to promote a blue economy in the Bay of Bengal continues to inspire our approach on maritime affairs. Bangladesh is considered one of the key emerging economic powerhouses in South Asia. It remains an important trading and investment partner for my country. Our exchanges have continued to grow rapidly during the last few decades. The great strides Bangladesh has made in the field of agriculture attract great attention in Sri Lanka. In addition to playing an active role through the SAARC Agricultural Center in Dhaka, Bangladesh continues to provide training and capacity building for our institutions. I seek your indulgence to share closer cooperation in this field. Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, the inspiring journey that the people of Bangladesh had undertaken from poverty and natural disasters in the past half century is a testament to a proposed nation in the making. It is in this backdrop I take this opportunity to extend my heartfelt compliments and sincere and warm wishes to you, Madam Prime Minister, your government, and the people of Bangladesh. Dhonnobad. Thank you.